he called me around 20 minutes to 11. He thought that we were going to be asleep at the New Year, so he wanted to call and wish us a Happy New Year. And his daughter was here at the time, along with my daughter, so he got to speak with her.
Little did his daughter and uncle know that that would be the last time they would speak to 40-year-old Officer Courtney Brooks. According to police, at 11:23, Officer Brooks was struck and killed on northbound 95 while working traffic detail. Derek says the family was watching the fireworks when they got the call.
This is definitely not the way that we thought we would be starting a new year. It's just absolutely devastating to the family.
Derek describes Officer Brooks as the jokester of the family at home, but always a consummate professional at work, a man who loved his job. Officer Brooks was engaged and was set to marry in May.
They just bought a house in Hampstead. They were getting married in May. I mean, everything was perfect. And just like that, it was just all taken away.
Officer Brooks is survived by his three children, 17-year-old Casey, 4-year-old Blake, and 2-year-old Reagan.
At some point, Blake will realize that his father's not coming home. Reagan at 2, she won't know. We'll have to show her video of her dad.
Derek says the family will cherish the last holiday they had with Brooks. They're still in shock, but they do have something to say to the person responsible.
The family is grief-stricken. If you are the person responsible for this, then we expect closure in this situation. Justice needs to be served.
And the family will now go from planning a wedding to arranging a funeral. At this point, no date has been set for the funeral. Reporting live here, Melissa Carlson, WBAL TV 11 News.
Melissa, thank you. And late today, Transportation Authority Chair John Porcari released this statement. This tragic incident that took the life of Officer Courtney Brooks underscores the importance of each and every person to drive safely. This is a tough day for the men and women of the MDTA police who place their lives on the line each day to protect us and our families. Today, we honor Officer Brooks for making the ultimate sacrifice in the line of duty. Our coverage of Officer Brooks' death continues on our website. On our photo gallery there, you will find video taken from the accident scene, shots from where police found the vehicle believed to be involved in the deadly crash, and most importantly, you can leave your condolences for the family. We hope you will. It's on the front page of our website, WBALTV.com.